It's a very good thing that they called it the God particle. It seems somebody wanted to call it the goddamn particle. So they just put God particle, and that's a very clever ploy, marketing ploy. You must be glad that scientists are becoming market savvy. They've always been, in a subtle way, now they're getting little overt. So, you know, for most people, their idea of science is just the new telephone model that's coming up. The next model of iPhone is their idea of science. All these people who never ever were interested in any kind of physics, now talking about particle physics world over, everybody's talking about particle physics. That's an achievement. Breaking a proton and coming up with a boson, is that an achievement? That needs to be seen. But it's definitely an achievement that suddenly the whole world, at least the educated part of the world, is thinking particle physics. That's an achievement. That's a good achievement. At least people are thinking of science as not a way of milking the existence. Not entirely, at least a little bit. They're willing to spend $10 billion just to know something. I like that. There is right now no technological use, but they're willing to spend $10 billion and 30 years just to know something. That sounds very spiritual to me. It usually doesn't cost that much, but so, having achieved one thing, having made a social goal, scientifically, what does it mean? In yoga, we see it this way. Existence is like this. There is something called as sthula, sukshma, shunya, shiva. Sthula means the gross existence. Physicality is sthula. Everything that you can see, everything that you can sense through five sense organs, everything that you can see, smell, taste, hear and touch is considered sthula. This can be analyzed with your intellect and understood and grasped. And this is always made of, as we know today, of anu or atoms, because it's physical in nature. It's a complete block of, building block of existence is an atom. And if it's made of an atom, once enough number of atoms are there, we can touch it, we can smell it, we can taste it, we can see it if it becomes big enough. Initially in a microscope, after that with our bare eyes, we could see it. But if it goes beyond the perception of the five senses, but still it is physical in nature, we call it sukshma. So when you enter into sukshma, it is still physical, but you are not able to grasp it. Do what you want, you cannot grasp it through five senses, nor can you analyze it through your intellect. That dimension, if you approach it, we call it visheshagnana or visheshagnana. That means an extraordinary knowledge. Gyan or jnana means knowledge. Visheshagnana is extraordinary or significant knowledge. So visheshagnana is referred to as vigyan. The word vigyan is being very loosely used today, but essentially it means this: those dimensions which cannot be perceived through five senses, if you perceive them, that is vigyan. So today, science is entering those spaces, because never ever is anybody going to see a Higgs boson. They are only going to see its footprint. Even now they only saw the footprint, they did not see a Higgs boson. But because they see the footprint, they believe he is there. Somebody has gone by, they left the footprints, we have not seen the man, but we know it's gone by. We go into the forest, we see the pug marks, and we say, okay, there is a tiger. We haven't seen the tiger. In fact, in a tropical forest, it's very difficult to see a tiger. But we will see pug marks here and there. Just like that, they saw the footprint. So they're entering vishesh jnana. If you go further, it will become shunya. That means absolute emptiness. There, your intellect will be completely useless. Your senses will be completely useless because there is no physicality. Where there is no physicality, your sense organs and intellect will become absolutely redundant. If you go beyond shunya, there is something that we refer to as Shiva. When I say Shiva, don't imagine that calendar man from Shivakashi. Shiva means that which is not. If you touch that which is not, we have always seen it is not physical in nature. It is not physical in nature means it does not exist, but it is opaque. How can that be? It is not in the realm of your logical mind. Today, modern science believes the whole existence has to oblige to human logic, which is a very limited way of approaching life. The whole existence will not oblige to human logic. You think you can fit the whole existence into your head. No, no, your head fits into the existence will not fit into your head. Your logic can analyze the physicality of the existence. Once you cross the physical dimension, your logic is completely out of its realm.